So imagine you have a company, and in a company you have a sales representative, sales rep, and that person communicates with all your customers, but the thing is, you want to replace this person, and you need to inform your customer about this. So technically, you sent an email that the person is replaced by a new person, right? But what kind of email do you send? So in this video, I'm going to show you what you can put in the email so you can use it. So let's go here. Like you know, we have for every letter a signature. So I'm going to put the signature already here. And we're going to write the letter. And while I'm writing the letter, I'm going to put some. No, I'm not going to put. Yeah, I'm going to put some music on what I'm thinking. And then you guys can listen to it. So let me choose the music first. Okay, it should be fine. So if you guys have questions, put it in the comments or go on the Discord, put it there, and then I will react on it. It's literally here. So let's start with the. I think it's better for me to start over again. Then I don't have to edit a lot. Otherwise, it's going to be complicated with editing. So tape two. Yeah. 3, 2, 1. Yeah. Okay. Imagine you have a company and you have a person, a sales representative that communicate with your customer. But the person just got fired or took another job and now works somewhere else, right? And you want to replace them. What you can do is you can send all your customer announcements. It can be an email or whatever you want. Okay? And the question is, what do you need to put in the email? So that's something we're going to discuss here. So before we start, I always put the signature so you see the ending. It's a signature that you're going to work towards it. I'm going to write this letter. And we're going to start first with the subject. So let's start with. Oh, I think I pressed something wrong. Give me a second. Yeah. We're going to start first with the subject. And then there's new area. New sales representative. Yeah. Yeah, so this is gonna be it, but this is the subject. So we're gonna put here subject. This is something you put in the subject, your sales representative, and then you're gonna start with dear. And remember, every letter you need to start with the name of the customer. Try to be as specific as possible. Yes, or madam. Yeah, I'm gonna write it down, and then we're gonna discuss it. Okay. Okay, so you can start, for example, with we recently made some change in our personnels in order to better serve our most valuable clients. First sentence, try to impress. As date, so put a date when the person is going to work as a representative. I am extremely pleased to inform you that in the name of the sales representative is now representing your company or the firm in the area. That's really important. So you're trying to be specific as possible and tell them what the person is, who the person is, and what he's doing, and who is representing. I'm gonna write now the second part, and then we're gonna discuss that also. Thank you. Okay, so if you look at the second part, you start with the name, it's an experience, and it's a great person you can count on. And here you put the name again, has been handling accounts in a region, because you're saying it's experience, so already did the same work in another region. And if he has knowledge about specific things, you can put it like this in the letter. Okay, so I'm gonna write this the third part and the last part, and then we're gonna discuss it, and then I'm gonna give you some tips about this letter. Okay, so technically, the last part, your new representative is scheduled to visit your office on, you put a date, of course, yeah? And then the name of the person will be calling you in the morning if that doesn't conflict with your schedule. Most of the time, the reason why you do this is because most of the time, you know when they are free. So example, if you work with a client a lot, you technically know when they are free, and so you can use this knowledge in order to plan an appointment. So if there's any problem with the date, let us know. Yeah, thanks for continuing to be one of our most appreciated clients. Yeah, so technically this is a simple letter, small letter, where you inform them or you make an announcement that you have a new sales representative in that area, and this is how you replace them. Make sure you talk about the knowledge of the sales representative, and also make sure that when you talk about the experience and stuff, that it's right. Because otherwise you're lying to your client. You don't want to do that. Remember, this is a template. That means you can change it however you want. If you have question about it, what you can do is just visit this link, www.martis.bio.link. When you go to the link, you join the Law Center, and in Law Center, you can ask me question, and in the question in Law Center, I can see it directly here. So you don't have to worry about that.